Hey folks, Kilt-Man, here, right here, at your service. You see Kilt-Man, in the Anderson tartan, Anderson, reds, blues, blacks, yellows, paler blue, darker blue, it's got everything, it's got shades of everything in it, and it is truly, truly gorgeous. Now, you see me folks in a state of somewhat disarray, yes. Because it's been a day, ups and downs, ups and downs. You get days like that where you just think, hey, no, you start off, everything's great, hunky-dory. And I started off by doing a video for you guys. I did. I thought, what can I do? I've got nothing new to unbox. I've got no new swords, no new axes, no new guns or knives or anything like that. I've got no new masks or props. I haven't even seen Joker yet, because it's not out yet, so I can't even review that. So what am I going to do? I mean, I wanted to give you a video, so I thought, well, why not carry on with the crest of the wave, having, you know, done loads for OMD, Orchestral Maneuvers in the Dark, who are making one hell of a comeback at the moment. Their UK tour is a sellout. I mean, absolute sellout. Except for Hull. There's still tickets left in Hull. If you really want to see them in hell. But and the reason why I know this is because Mrs. Kilt-Man said to me only yesterday, she went, oh, do you know, OMD, all the tickets have sold out. And I went, oh right, mate. She goes, I was trying to get you some. Oh, you were trying to get me some tickets. Well, yeah, I was, but that now, obviously, no, it's no can do. I thought, why tell me? Why don't you just leave me in the dark? Now I'm like, oh. And that set the tone for the day. So, I did a little video playing some more OMD, but a bit more vintage stuff. I played The Great Telegraph. I played The Great, what else did I play? Talking Loud and Clear. And I discussed the videos. I even gave a little tribute to Andy McCluskey's wild signature dance. You know, all this kind of crazy fucking shit. And I was doing all that. And it went on. And then I'm on the train going to work. Hey, I'll just put the links on so people know there's a video there. Email off YouTube. Your video has been removed! Kilt-Man, how dare you? How dare you infringe upon copyright licenses? What? I've been doing this all the time? What the hell? And then I realised I didn't put my little disclaimer on at the bottom. Oh, maybe that's it. But either way, it doesn't matter. The video was removed and much fun that I had, you will no longer see. Anyway, then the plus side crept in. Scotland were playing in the World Cup, Rugby World Cup in Japan. Yeah, and they absolutely fucking battered Samoa. Yes, those big Samoans. They crumbled under the might of Scotland. Samoans didn't even get a single point. Ooh, not one. Scotland got that many, I've actually forgotten. I think it was 37. Something like that, anyway, can't remember. But brilliant, brilliant. So I was that happy and I thought, well, it's payday, Scotland have won. So look, come on now. You need some more stuff. So you need some content for these videos. You know me and me masks? So I went to buy two masks. I phoned up to order them online from my favourite supplier and my card was declined. Declined, you say? It's payday. It hasn't gone through. What? Hasn't gone through? But I've been using my card all day. You know, I've bought other stuff. How come it's not working for you guys? Oh, your best bet is go to the bank. So I thought, oh, maybe it's a fraud squad or something like that. It's a dodgy payment. They just don't like the looks of it. You know, the fraud squad can randomly jump upon a payment. And you've just got to say, yeah, it's me. I'm making that payment, yeah. So it goes to the bank, don't I? And I end up sitting there for an hour, waiting to see somebody. And then I explained everything, and they went, so look at your system. Oh, yeah. Do you wear a kilt all the time? Yeah. Yeah, I do. Yeah. I do YouTube videos, in fact. Do you? On kilts? No. Well, sometimes. But, you know, no, it's mainly like horror movies and horror movie masks, which I've just been trying to buy, and the card's been declined. And he said, well, your card's got no stops on it. It's not blocked. Your card is perfectly fine. In fact, how much was the payment for? That's there. Payment's going through. Son of a bitch! I've just spent almost an hour sitting there waiting to be told there's nothing wrong anyway. Oh my God. So I phoned up the supplier and he proceeded to say, well, that is maybe, but it hasn't come through at this end. It might just be that there's a problem. We had this the other weekend, so maybe it's just that. And it should be okay tomorrow. Don't worry, the masks are yours. They're allocated to you. So I left the bank. And what had been a glorious day, well, half a day. Yeah, the sun was beaming down. I wouldn't say it was warm, but I wouldn't say it was cold. And I was just in a t-shirt. I don't normally wear a t-shirt, I normally wear a vest, but I wore a gorgeous Escape from New York t-shirt. And my hair was all Snake Plissken flouncy. Oh, yes, yes. Fucking heavens opened, didn't they? You know, rain on my parade. Okay, I was absolutely drenched through. You know when Miss Wet t-shirt contest? Oh, well, my boobage was sticking right out, nipples like bullets. Not a pretty sight, I'll give you that, but oh my God, drenched through. And I think the colours run on the print on the Escape from New York t-shirt as well. Life, folks, does this to us. And it's not what life does to us, it's how we deal with what life does to us. And I went fucking mad! No, I didn't. I took it in my stride. Because, hey ho, these things are sent to try us. If we didn't have these little dilemmas, if everything was given to us on a gilded platter, where'd be the fun in that? Let me just rethink that. That'd be a lot of fun in that, actually. I suppose it depends who's presenting you with that gilded platter. Topless cheerleaders on roller skates. Exotic. Ballroom dancers just wearing stockings and high heels. Oh, sorry, I'm still recording, aren't I? But fear not, these masks will be with me at some point. And once they're with me, they'll be with you as well. Now, for those of you who haven't noticed, it's now October, or Shocktober, as I like to call it, because now we've entered Halloween season. This is the season of the witch. This is pure Michael Myers, pure Halloween, pure black magic, occult, devils, werewolves, vampires, monsters, aliens, everything that creeps and scuttles about in the shadows is going to come out and have its day. Every day throughout October. So what that means for you guys and this channel is one hell of a lot of horror movie reviews coming your way, including one later on, because I've already got one in the bank, as it were. So hope you're up for like a bit of blood-curdling shrieks and groans and moans and screams and hollers and gibbering howls of agony and terror, because that's what's coming your way. And that's just when you see me with no top on. But I love this time of year. I love Christmas. I love every time of year. I love summertime. But there's something about October, the autumn. Once you've turned that corner out of summer and you've gone into October, the leaves change colour, the leaves drop. The temperature drops a little bit and you get the wind coming in and the rustling of the leaves and you just get that autumnal smell. It's just, I love it, love it. And the nights begin to draw in a bit, right? And you can see how the old druids and the old pagans used to think, like, oh shit, the sun's gone. The dead will walk the earth again, our ancestors. We must protect ourselves, make offerings and sacrifices and all sorts of weird shenanigans to keep the bogeyman at bay. You can see why, And, we still celebrate Halloween, although it's massively commercialised now. There's a lot of things I'm going to discuss in the ensuing weeks, because I think there's a lot to discuss, and a lot of fun stuff to be had as well. So be prepared for lots and lots of movie reviews. Hopefully I'm going to try and celebrate some unsung and neglected classics, some hidden gems of the horror genre, some vintage stuff, some modern stuff, some overlooked stuff, but just great stuff that, I'm going to try and put it this way. I'm not going to put anything on that I don't like, and if I like it, I'll be enthusiastic, and hopefully that will, whether you like it or not, you'll at least be entertained. So you know, bolt your doors, lock your windows, batten down the hatches, grab your crucifix, because things are going to get frightening in the old kilted domain. Behind us playing is Captain Kronos, Vampire Hunter, one of Hammer's greatest and most unusual tales. I have covered it before, so, you know, troll back. I've covered the soundtrack and I've covered the movie, which I think is tremendous. Love the music to it. But stay tuned, because there's going to be something coming later on. No, I was going to give some clues, but I won't. So, let me just go and dry off. The irony is, I've got to dry off now and then take the dog out for a walk. It is still absolutely persisting down. Kilt-Man, you know what you said before? You know, the ups and downs, the yin and the yang. It's how you deal with it that counts. With whiskey, that's how I deal with it. With whiskey! No. Folks, take it easy. Keep dry. Keep out of this inclement weather. And stay safe. At least until you see me next. In the meantime, I'm going to see you all.